In this video, I want to share with you how you can take Halloween patterns from Canva and put them into letters in Affinity Designer so that you can make designs like this one right here and hopefully get some sales this Halloween. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005, and in this video I wanted to teach you a Halloween technique. Actually, this technique can be used for any holiday, and that is putting patterns into fonts or into text. I'm gonna do it in Affinity Designer, and you can use any pattern from any place. Canva has a ton of patterns, so I'm just gonna go there, but of course you can get your patterns from Vecteezy or Vexels or Creative Fabrica or wherever you get your patterns. You can even make your own patterns if you want to, but I'm gonna show you, if you have a pattern already, how to put it into letters. And this can be used for Halloween as well as Thanksgiving and Christmas and any major holiday really, but I see it a lot during Halloween, so I'm gonna show you how you can do it in Halloween really easy, an easy way to do it. So let's get into Canva first so that we can find, I'll show you how to find these patterns, what patterns I'm gonna use. Of course, you can don't have to follow me. You can use any pattern you want. And then I'm gonna go into Affinity Designer and do it real quick, put it into text. It's gonna be super simple. You can follow along step by step. Let's get into Canva right now though. So here I am on Canva. I've already added an artboard here. We're just gonna go to Elements and we can type in pattern. So Halloween pattern specifically, and you can even do by color. So I'm gonna do Halloween pattern black, right? And you can see a lot of black patterns here. You can pick any one that you want. A lot of them are gonna be pro. If you did free version, I'm gonna just do free, and you're gonna see how little patterns there are for free. I mean, there are some, so you could use that. But one of the nice things about Pro is there's a ton of patterns. And let me just use the Pro stuff. And you can see lots more here. I'm gonna click off of this. That's a nice black pattern. Let's do this one. You can see it is black, but we can do black on white. You can do a rectangle, so just hit R as a rectangle and make the rectangle black. Or purple, whatever color you want, really. And then you can change this one to white and make sure this is in the front. Oh, there we go. So now we have a black pattern. We're gonna do four of these because the one that I'm gonna do, the word I'm gonna do, has four letters. So we want four different patterns. We don't have to, but we can. So here's a nice pattern here. Let's do, actually, that one, that's really complex. Let's do another one. This one right here, here's a nice white one. Do that, different colors. Let's look for an orange one. That's kind of cool. That's more, well, let me try orange here. Halloween pattern orange. Yeah. This one's kind of neat. Again, you can pick any one that you want here. And then let's do maybe a purple one. Let's see if there's a purple one. That's kind of cool. Yeah, cool. Again, any one we want. Doesn't really matter. We could have picked any one of these, right? Bats. I would just pick ones that are different. That's kind of what we're doing, just picking ones that are different. I'm gonna add another artboard just to add some variety. So we got these for the patterns. I may wanna do some spiders, right, on top of it. So spiders, I like this one right here. And we wanna look for one that can change the color. So we may wanna do this on a black t-shirt so we can change it to white, you know, or whatever color we want. So I'm gonna do it black, but when we get into Affinity Designer, we definitely can change this color because this is one of those. Let's see, let's try another, maybe a hanging spider. Well, we got that, spider webs. Let's do other spider webs, let's see what else they got. Is this one that you can change the color? Yep, yeah. Let's see, oh, well, let's do bats. Yeah, this is fun. This one. No, see, this one you can't change the color. So this is just a graphic. I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna do this one. Yeah, so this one you can change the color right there. So we need to change it black to white. Ooh, this is kind of cool. That's kind of cool. Let's use that too. And good, I think this is enough. Oh, this is a cool pattern. Let me go back. What if we did that? Yeah. All right, anyway, you can see I can change out patterns. So we got our four patterns, we got this. We're gonna download it. We're gonna make sure that it is not PNG. We're gonna do PDF standard. You might have seen the trick that I did in this video right here. I'll put it up here. We're gonna use the PDF with Canva and Affinity Designer, and we'll download these two pages and bring it into Affinity Designer, and I'll show you how to put these patterns into some text. So here I am in Affinity Designer. I have my artboard, the 4500 by 5400 artboard, Amazon size. I also have the PDF from Canva. So I'm gonna select all of these right here, and I'm gonna hit Command C to copy. And then I'm gonna go back to here and hit Command V. And you can see it's bigger than the artboard. So there they are, all of these right here. I'm gonna zoom back in and type out some text. So I'm just gonna do the word mama, four letters, M-A-M-A, make it bigger here. And I'm gonna use a font that I like. It's called Cooper Black. You can use any font that you want, but I'm gonna type in Cooper, whoops, C-O-O-P. You may or may not have this font. This is a nice vintage font here, kind of rounded. So the next thing I'm gonna do is convert these to curves when I have it the right size. I'm gonna go from like edge to edge right here. Hit convert to curves and ungroup these. So you can see each one of these is its own group. And now I'm gonna take these patterns and just put them inside of these letters, really simple. So the first one right here, whoops, I forgot I made these two things. So let's group all of this right here. So this one is one. Let's see. Yeah, this is two, three, good, four. Good. So let's kind of do dark, light, dark, light. So dark being the black one first. Let's put it under the M here. If we click on this M, I forgot I had these. Let's group these. There we go. And is this one group? All right, so that's what it was doing. All right, so now you can see the M-A-M-A. So the first thing we're gonna do, now that we got this, we're gonna take that group right here and put it inside the M. So we'll do there. You can see it inside. Let me zoom in. Now let's just make it the right size here. There it is, that pattern. So I did that pretty quick. Let's do this again. Here's the A, the second A, right? Let's take this right here. See that? And drag it into that A here. And now we're gonna just see it. Super simple. Let's just make sure it's like that. This M here can be the purple one. So there's the purple group. We'll drag it and inside the M and just make it the right size. And then lastly, the A here. So we have our pattern here. Let's just make sure it's inside the A. There we go. There you go. So that's a quick way to have the patterns inside the letters. Let's make sure this background is black since most of the Halloween t-shirts are gonna be black. Okay, so what can help here is an outline around it. And I'm gonna give it two outlines, a black one and a white one. So let's close these. And here's the M. I'm gonna copy it twice, hit Command J right there. So the first outline here is gonna be black. So let's just do a black outline right here. And we'll give it a stroke. And we can't really see it because the background's black. So let's change the black background to something lighter. Okay. There we go, we can see the background now and that curve, this middle one right here. Let's do the stroke. little bigger. I got it at 11 points. So the very back one, let's make that white. So we just click all of these to white and make sure our stroke is bigger than the other one. It was 11, so it's gonna have to be, you know, maybe 20 or so. See that? So all of these together are the M. So I would group this together right here. So that's M, and now we can move it in back or in front. Now we can do this with this one too. So let's do the same thing. J, J, Command J, Command J. The middle one again, remember, was 11. So we're gonna do black here and make sure the stroke is at 11. Now it would be different on yours, but we wanna make sure that it's the same as the first one. So the first one is 11. So we'll make sure all of these are 11. And the bottom one again, take here and go white. And we did it at 20, right? Just make sure it's all white. And oh, stroke at 20. And we can do that for all the letters here. And we can make it, you know, if you don't want the black outline that thick, we can come back in here and say, oh, maybe it should be 10 because it's 10 and 20. And we'd probably do the same thing for this one. Or you could make it 9, or you can make it whatever size you want, right? And again, you could make these, it doesn't have to be white. If you wanted it orange, come in here, play around with the colors. Maybe instead of white, you want orange here. Maybe like a 3000, see? And these are now all together, so you could move it in the front and kinda do it like that if you want it to, right? So you can do it any way you want. You could do the middle, if you wanted the middle one of the M, a white instead of black, of course you could do that too. So we're just giving it two outlines, right? You see how that's working? So kind of a fun thing to do with two outlines. Now I'm gonna do all these in a different outline and I'll come back and I'll show you what happens. We'll just do the same thing, Command J, Command J, pick the different colors and we'll have the outlines. All right, so here I'm back. I did the outlines on the different ones. I did orange on the M's and white on the A's. You can do whatever one you want and you can mix up the patterns and it doesn't have to be black, orange, purple, white, right? It could be black, white, whatever you want. I'm just gonna show you what else I'm gonna do to this. I may wanna put another word on here or two. So I'm typing in the word spooky. Can't see it because it's black. Let's do it in white because this is a black t-shirt. And I don't know if I typed it right. Let's see. Nope, because I couldn't see what I was doing. Spooky. I'm gonna use a cursive font. So one of my favorites here, I'm just gonna do intro script demo. But of course you can use any script font you want, or it doesn't even have to be a script font. And there's Spooky Mama. And let's use some of the things that we got here. So let's move all of these here, including this guy. Let's see how this would look under here. Looks like it might do really well. I'm gonna make it white. That's looking cool. Move it in the back. Yeah, and maybe this, flip it. That's kind of cool, move that in the back. I can't see these guys' bats, so I'm gonna color the bats white so that we can see them. Yeah, that's looking cool. Let's see, we could use another bat here. Again, you can use any graphics you want. And I don't know if we need this guy here. I think we're fine with the spider webs. Well, maybe, let me turn it. Let's see what we can do here. I don't know if it's gonna match because it's a different kind of spider web. It's a little thinner. Maybe put it up here. Does that match? Yeah, it's too thin. It's too thin. It would have to be thicker. So let's just take that out. You don't have to use every graphic. So there we go, Spooky Mama for Halloween. Again, we're incorporating graphics, different texts, different kind of styles. I think this would really, really be cool. I don't know if Spooky Mama is trending. You're gonna have to look what different phrases are. I'm just showing you the techniques, right? Grab graphics from Canva, make sure that you can come back in here and color them. And then you can see I'm just incorporating it with the patterns that we did, really easy, and the outlines, and you can move things around. So that's this tutorial in Affinity Designer using things from Canva again, with that PDF. Real easy to do, and make your own stuff. And again, use different words, use different patterns, use different graphics. I'm just showing you how I did this one, but of course the sky's the limit. You got lots of different things. I would say try it out with different words, short words, long words. Do your research, see what kind of words, or come up with your own phrase that would be even better, and put in these patterns, I think, would be really cool for this Halloween. So that is it for this video. I really like how it turned out. You can see you can do a lot with Canva and Affinity Designer together, especially if you have the pro version of Canva. I'm gonna put a link in the description to the pro version of Canva. Just so many different patterns that you can use. Of course, there's patterns in the free version too. Try them all out, see what you like about them. It's a really good combo, and which is what I said in one of my other videos. So have fun with this one. If this video was really helpful for you, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed already to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button. I got a lot more tutorials coming, especially for Halloween. It's one of the biggest holidays out there. Starting the Q4 sales picks up in October and just goes all the way till the end. So you really want to get in on the Halloween designs. It's my biggest month, usually is October. So have fun with this one. The question of the day for this video is, what other Halloween patterns or Halloween designs do you want to learn how to make? Let me know in the comments below. I would love to teach you how to do other graphic design styles. Thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more design tutorials, click on these right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.